Dairy Queen is a chain of soft-serve ice cream and fast food restaurants that opened in 1940. Thank you for your suggestion.
Hey gang, look what's new at Dairy Queen. It's our new summer treat pail, complete with hot dog or burger, fries, soft drink, Wassa Dairy Queen cone. Great for beach or backyard. Hurry, grab mom and dad and get to Dairy Queen. Supplies are limited.
The first Dairy Queen opened on 501 North Chicago Street in Joliet, Illinois in 1940. The founders of Dairy Queen, J.F. Grandpa McAuliffe and his son Alex, originally established the homemade ice cream company in 1927. The two men sold a variety of ice cream products throughout the Quad Cities area. In order to expand their operations, during the 1930s, the McAuliffes moved their business to Green River, Illinois, and purchased a former cheese factory in which they located their ice cream mix plant. The elder McAuliffe developed a different type of semi-frozen ice cream by using a special freezer to dispense the product. Hence, the soft-serve ice cream was created. The McAuliffes arranged to test their new product in an ice cream retail shop in Kankakee, Illinois, owned by Sherb Noble. Noble held an all-you-can-eat for 10 cents sale on an August afternoon. More than 1,600 people lined up to try the new treat, and the McAuliffes knew they had a business opportunity. The first Dairy Queen opened in Joliet, Illinois on June 22, 1940. Jointly owned by the McAuliffes and Sherb Noble, the store was managed by Jim and Elliot Grace. By the end of the summer, the store had grossed $4,000 and Noble decided to buy out the McAuliffes' interest in that store. J.F. McAuliffe often referred to the cow as the queen of the dairy business. Thus, the Dairy Queen name originated. On April 1, 1941, the McAuliffes opened another store in Moline and once again contracted the Graces to manage it for them. Additional stores were opened in Aurora, Illinois and Davenport, Iowa, and by the end of 1942, there were a total of 8 Dairy Queen businesses in operation. During the war, father and son sold rights to would-be store owners to use the Dairy Queen freezer and mix and develop business in certain geographical areas of the country. Since they both suspected that the popularity of Dairy Queen would be brief, it was more sensible to the McAuliffes to sell territories outright rather than to arrange an ongoing royalty system. All profits were up front. And if the product lost its appeal, there was no fear of losing any income. Unfortunately, the McAuliffes' method of contracting the development of new territories was extremely informal, sometimes scribbled on a napkin, paper sack, or daily newspaper, and this led to a host of problems later on. Impressed with the long lines at the Dairy Queen store in Moline, Harry Axine, a sales manager from a farm equipment company, approached Grandpa McAuliffe and soon became a 50-50 partner in the mixed company. He also purchased the territory rights for Illinois and Iowa at a price of $12,000. By the end of the war, Axine had purchased the remaining interests in the mixed company and, more importantly, had seen the future of Dairy Queen in franchising. Excited about organizing a national Dairy Queen franchise system, Axine introduced the idea of selling territories based on a royalty system where territory store owners would pay Axine an initial fee plus an ongoing royalty fee for the soft serve mix. By the end of 1946, there were 17, and by the end of 1947, there were over 100 Dairy Queen stores operating throughout the United States. The Dairy Queen National Trade Association, or the DQNTA, was created in order to standardize cones, plastic goods, and all other materials used in Dairy Queen stores, along with coordinating all the various kinds of advertising for the Dairy Queen products. By the early 1950s, there were over 900 members. There were 1,400 Dairy Queen stores open for business in 1950, and up until that time, the menu was limited to sundaes and cones for immediate consumption. When supermarkets began to sell ice cream at low prices, and when air conditioning and television began keeping people home on those sultry summer evenings, sales in Dairy Queen stores across the country began to suffer. In order to keep attracting customers, most stores responded to requests for an expanded menu. In 1949, milkshakes and malts were made available, and banana splits were added in 1951. Toppings for sundaes were also expanded. Take-home novelty products were also introduced, including the Dilly Bar, a soft-serve chocolate-dipped confection with a wooden tongue depressor inserted for the customer to hold while eating. During the 1950s, Dairy Queen stores were also challenged by the emergence of fast food outlets that offered hamburgers, hot dogs, french fries, and various soft drinks. Since these outlets served full meals, they remained open the entire year. Dairy Queen stores were put at a disadvantage since they were boarded up for most of the winter season. In order to stay competitive, store operators in different parts of the country began to offer various food products, from bowls of chili to pork fritters. Yet, the lack of a standardized menu brought complaints from customers until the brazier system of broiled burgers, hot dogs, barbecue beef, french fries, and onion rings was introduced in 1958. By the 1960s, legal battles ensued over franchise, territorial, and trade name rights between Axing, the McAuliffes, and franchisees. And by 1962, for $1.5 million in cash, McAuliffe relinquished his claim to all territory and trade name rights. By 1955, there were over 2,600 store locations, and by the early 1960s, International Dairy Queen, IDQ, would take over for the DQNTC. In May of 1972, the first Dairy Queen store was opened in Tokyo, while 75 stores were operating outside the United States and Canada in 1976, more than 150 stores in Barbados, Guatemala, Iceland, Japan, Panama, Puerto Rico, Trinidad, the United Arab Emirates, and Hong Kong were operating by the end of the decade. By the 1970s, Dairy Queen becomes the third largest fast food chain in the United States. By 1980, Dairy Queen had 4,314 stores in operation in the United States, with 365 in Canada, 123 in Japan, and over 30 in 8 other foreign countries. During this time, Dairy Queen introduces drive-thrus in its stores and other products such as the Peanut Butter Parfait and Fudge Brownie Delight, both of which were highly successful novelty products. However, it was the introduction of the Blizzard, a concoction of soft-serve ice cream blended with candy, cookies, or fruit that secured Dairy Queen's ranking as the number one treat chain during the 1980s. In 1985 alone, the year it was introduced, the Blizzard achieved sales of over 100 million units. During the 1980s, Dairy Queen acquired the Golden Skillet, a chain of fried chicken restaurants, Caramel Corn Shops, a 60-year-old popcorn and candy franchise, and Orange Julius, a franchise selling fruit-flavored blended drinks and various snack products. In 1997, the company would be sold to Berkshire Hathaway. Investment guru Warren Buffett controlled Berkshire, which would pay $585 million in stock and cash. In 2001, Dairy Queen begins to roll out the DQ Grill and Chill format at select restaurants. DK Grill and Chill locations feature hot food, treats, table delivery, and self-serve soft drinks. The company's stores are operated under several brands, all bearing the Dairy Queen logo and carrying the company's signature soft-serve ice cream. Brazier locations with expanded food menus and second floors for storage are recognizable by their red mansard roofs. By the end of 2014, Dairy Queen had more than 6,400 stores in 27 countries, including more than 1,400 outside the United States and Canada. Today, there are over 5,700 Dairy Queen stores throughout the world. Dairy Queen is the largest seller of soft frozen dessert products in the world. Thank you for watching. If you like this content, and if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Thanks.